on CBBC, it's time for my favourite show. It's obviously Hacker Time, Cocker. Here it is, the multi-award nominated episode featuring everyone's favourite tennis woman, Sue Barker. Here it is.
You gotta watch this. You gotta watch this. You gotta watch this. My program hits you so hard, makes me say, oh my word. Thank you for watching me, it's telly, but not waiting, obviously it feels good. There's outtakes too, comedy gets some clips, it's true. So sit back, don't move too much, this is the show but you can't touch. So Hacker Time. Thank you.
Poker face!
What's he doing now?
Derek, what are you doing? We're doing the question of sport music here, not Lady Gaga.
Oh, not Lady Gaga. Oh, heck. I must have got the wrong memo.
You've completely ruined my well-planned, spontaneous introduction. Get back to the gallery, Derek. Go on, get out of here!
Oh, will you answer that, Mr. Hacker?
I will not answer that.
But I'm waiting for a quote on me grouting.
Grouting? I'm trying to make a TV show here. Now get out, Derek. Don't go anywhere, viewers. It will get better than this, I promise. Coming up today, criminal activity. You nicked that.
It's the Wimbledon trophy.
Sporting prowess. And probing questions. How much do you weigh?
What?
Sit tight, folks. Today's programme is going to be all about sport. So there's only one person qualified to be my guest today. She's lovely, she's talented, and she's not returned my calls for weeks now. Herman Wealth, go and get her.
Yes, Mr. Hacker.
I'll fire up the vine.
Stay there, love. Off you go, Wealth. Off we go!
We can't do this! Who are you? And where are you taking me?
On the reverse chair.
Please welcome today's special guest, my close personal friend, Sue Barker!
It's you! I might have known.
Hello, Sue.
Hi,
I've
Hacker.
Missed you.
I've missed you too, but what am I doing here?
Well, I thought you might like to be my special guest today on Hacker Time.
Oh, I don't think I've got time. You know, I am a very busy woman. I've got a lot of sport to present and I've got my dry cleaning to collect as well, so...
Oh, Susan, don't leave me. I've planned a whole show about sport and if you won't do it, the only other guest available is Dennis Tennis.
Dennis, he doesn't know anything about sport. God, he'd never be a good sports presenter like me. I mean, imagine what would happen, Hacker.
Hello, and welcome to the sport. Like, oh, me head's come amiss.
Well, I tell you what, if it's between Dennis Tennis and me, then I'm in.
Perfect. Sorry, Dennis, you're off the show. Bit strange, that one. Now, Susan, I've prepared some definitely true facts about
you. It's Susan.
Who? Susan Barker.
Right.
I've prepared some definitely true facts about you. Pull that lever. Perfect. Sue Barker is a lovely woman. But don't be fooled, because she spent a lot of her early years in court. The tennis court, of course. Sue gave her tennis rackets a lot of love and care. There. Go to sleep now, tennis racket. Oh, tennis racket! Since 1993, she has been a presenter on BBC Sport. Sue wears a variety of different outfits. Here she is in a white jacket now. And here she is in a white jacket. And there she is in a white jacket again. What are you doing, Sue? Maybe she just wants to make friends now. But we know her now for a question of sport, where she never gets within 3 metres of Phil Tufnell.
Huh?
Sue's got loads of fans. Even worms want to take her picture. And she's my dream woman. So that's everything you need to know about Susan Barker. Ooh. That was good, wasn't it?
Well, it wasn't all true, you know.
Some of it was. The white jacket bit was accurate.
No, I almost wore it today.
I wish you had, Sue. Oh, Sue, it's so lovely to have you here. I normally have a right load of old has-beens on here, but you're a proper woman. And now I am going to interview you like a real presenter, unlike Gary Lineker would.
Okay.
Question one. Do you remember when you stole that big plate from Wimbledon canteen?
No.
Yes, you did, love. I've got a photographic evidence thing. Look at this. You nicked that.
It's the Wimbledon trophy. It's the ladies' trophy.
Oh, yeah. That's what all minor criminals say, Sue.
The closest I got to it was holding it there.
And so, do you remember when you had that question of sport hat?
No.
Well, I do. And I have evidence, Sue. Look at it. What do you think?
Where did it... That's... terrible.
Hey, Sue, yes. What about that time when the Sports Personality of the Year trophy said something to offend you? You were livid then, weren't you?
I was seeing red.
Did it vex you, Sue?
Well, again, that's another trophy I didn't win, you see, so yeah. I wasn't happy with it.
There's loads of trophies you've not
won. I know,
Sue.
Exactly.
Sue!
Yes?
You present sports stuff on the telly, don't
I
you?
I do, yes.
I like watching you, but I must admit, I do find it a bit confusing at times. Will you clear up a few things for me?
I'll try.
All right. Is squash a sport or a drink?
Well, it's both.
Is juice a tennis score or a drink?
It's both.
Is tea a thing you use in golf or a drink?
It's both, Hacker.
Oh, it's so confusing, Sue.
It is.
And it's made me all very thirsty.
Has it?
Now, where was it? Oh, yes. Susan Barker.
Yes.
Do you remember that time when I was a guest on Question of Sport?
You've never been a guest on Question of Sport.
Susan! How could you? It meant so much to me. Have a look at this video evidence.
Who, having won the 2008 Olympic women's 50 metres and 100 metres freestyle, won the same events a year later at the World Championships?
Let me just write that down.
I love you, why are you scribbling?
Take your time.
Is that a question of sport?
It is.
Thank you. Yeah, cheers. Thank you very much. Oh, cheers, cockers. Hey, what do you think, Sue?
I'm very impressed and incredible sporting knowledge, obviously.
Thank you. I have got the mind of an intellect. Hang on, what's happening now?
Hello, folks. Derek McGee here, taking matters into my own hands once again for Derek time. Hoo-hoo! It's Derek time. How do, Derek fans? Today on Derek Time, we haven't got time to show you the Wimbledon player disqualified for lying about his age. Oh, the kitten that forgets he isn't Tom Daly. But we have got time to show you today's top clip. This kitty's trying to have a little cat nap, but he's not accounted for his lack of a headrest. See? He's woken up. Oh, he's going to fall off again. I hope the same fate doesn't befall him again. Oh, what do you know it has? The only thing that would make this funnier is if it happened a third time. And what do you know? It has. What a bizarre cat. That's it for Derek time. Tune in next week for more highbrow entertainment. See ya.
Oh, I'm sorry about him, Sue. He's a disgrace, but he's cheap.
Fair enough. Well, that's why Phil Tufnell's still on Question of Sport.
Hey, there's nothing cheap about this bit, though, Sue.
Really?
Hit it! When I was a puppy, I made a discovery of a woman so lovely. I couldn't resist. She hosted the sports, offered insightful thoughts at the Wimbledon courts. Yes, I was hooked. Oh, she's got a strong backhand, a legion of loyal fans.
always interesting, never bland. Oh, you didn't get that with Desmond Lynam. She does a question of sport, interviews the winners on Centre Court. There is only one Susan Barker, a staple of public life since 1973. There is only one Susan Barker.
What do you think, Sue?
I love my favourite tune, and the words were lovely.
Thank you, Susan. Sue Barker.
You didn't have to mention 1973, though.
It was contractual.
What a ridiculous programme. Benjamin, we need to write a letter of complaint to the BBC.
OK, Frank, should I write it down?
Yes. No. No, every time we've done this, you've got it wrong. Let's email the complaint instead. Not even you can mess that up.
Oh, yeah.
Now go and get the keyboard.
The keyboard?
Yes, the keyboard.
Well, if you say so, Frank.
Yeah, OK. Ahem. Dear the BBC, please stop screening this disgraceful Hacker Time muck. You are sullying the good name of the fragrant Susan Barker. Benjamin, what are you doing?
Well, you did say get the keyboard, Frank.
Benjamin!
Hacker, did you hear something?
Was it the sound of my beating heart telling you that I love you, Sue?
No, it was more like rats or cockroaches, something like that.
Oh, yeah, that figures. This place is riddled, Sue. Anyway, Susan, don't mind me. I just need to do a little bit of my presenting stuff. You're watching Hacker Time with today's very special guest, Susan Barker off the sports things. She's having a lovely time. In fact, I'd probably say this is the best day of her life.
What am I doing here? Claire Balding's having a fondue party tonight. I could be eating some Emmental whilst chatting to Jake Humphrey about skeleton bobsleigh instead of having to listen to this rubbish.
Hello? Sue?
Yeah.
Susan?
Yeah.
Yeah, I said you're having a lovely time, aren't you?
I'm having a great time. I'm having a great time.
I knew you would, Sue. Well, there's more good news, Sue.
Well, is it over?
No.
Oh.
The good news is that there's still loads more to come. Run the menu, Derek.
Still to come?
There's been an incident.
More sporting prowess. And more probing questions.
What was the score?
I don't know.
7 it was.
But first, Hacker's off to meet his fans.
Here you go. Here we go. All right, Cockers.
Hello, Hacker.
Hello, it's me, Hacker. Do you not think you could help me to become a major sporting athlete?
Yeah!
You do? Hooray! Then let the training drill begin. Right, you, jog on the spot. Come on, faster. Feel your arteries quivering. Working out is lots of fun.
Working out is lots of fun.
Unless you fall on your bum.
Unless you go on your
book. Can you do any yoga moves?
Yes.
What's that one called?
The tree.
Faster! Faster! Come on, faster! Oh, I think my tree's got woodworm. Timber! It is now time for the greatest sporting challenge ever. This requires great skill and prowess. I want you to sort out my stinking laundry. There's 10 pair of socks in there that need matching up. Go! Oh, them are underpants. No, no, them are my knickknacks. Don't look at them. Come on, pair up some socks. Come on, it's a challenge. It's a time against the clock challenge. Time's up. Stop, time's up. How many have you managed to do?
None.
Perfect. How about you?
Two.
Two pairs. And how about you?
No idea.
He's no idea, which means the laundry challenge has proved one thing and one thing only, that it was a total waste of time. Good day. So what have we learned today? Number one, sport requires great physical strength. Number two, laundry is not technically a sport. And number three, I can do a great dolphin impression. Thanks for all your help, Cockers.
Now back to the studio. I bet they're having a miserable time there without me. Everyone, I'm back! What do you call this? Stop the music, please! Put the lights onto the normal setting. I'm not happy about this. What's... Susan? I've been off there doing all that serious stuff. And you're here, acting the giddy goose with a man dressed as a lemon. What's happened to you, Sue?
I'm sorry, Hacker.
Yeah. And as for you pesky costume characters, I think you better apologise as well.
Sorry, Hacker.
There's only one thing that's going to make me feel better now, Sue. And that's looking at a few hilarious lols from when a question of sport went adrift. That means you, Susan. Run the tape, Derek!
Starting tonight with a picture board behind
us. Sue Barker, you made a fool of yourself. Oh, no, not Anton. He was in Serie 1.
Easy, just for the start with.
Uh-oh.
Here we are. Just follow me.
Spin around, Anton.
I can't see where I'm going.
Don't have to look.
Spin around.
Defending is worth taking, though.
Checking.
Come on, Sue. Quick. Time's money, love.
Look, someone's speaking to you, Sue, right?
They're checking.
She just goes off in the...
Tufnell, keep out of this. Don't you mock my Sue. Tufnell!
Excuse me.
Tell you what, I'm lucky tonight because I have my stunt.
Hang on, which one's Sue? Which one's Sue?
I'm going to tell you, my wildest dreams have seen two Sue Barkers.
Double Sue.
End of the buzz around, and now it's a win for Matt's team. 17 points. Sorry.
Sue, it's Phil. Phil won. It's a basic science, that. Oh. Well done, Sue. No one noticed. Spin around, Anton. That's it. Elevator. Oh, don't drop her. Mind your espadrilles. Anton. Oh, no. Sue. Oh. They were good, weren't they, Sue?
They were.
What about that Anton?
Did you see that? He threw me over his shoulder.
Oh, good old Anton. He's crackers, isn't he?
He is.
Now then, Sue.
Right.
You are rather top-notch at hosting a question of sport, if you don't mind me saying. Oh,
thank you very much, Hacker.
No problem. But I think I could do it better.
Oh, yeah? Well, you've got the hair.
I've got one of my classic standard Sue Barker wigs on. So I thought I would now do a top-draw quiz entitled A Question of Sue. Welcome to A Question of Sue. My name is Hecate Dog, and playing tonight is everyone's favourite Sue, Sue Barker!
Ooh, I'm worried about this.
Oh, you should be worried, Sue. There are three rounds and plenty of points up for grabs. Right. No prize at the end of it, but you can't have everything, can you, love? We've had a budget cut, haven't we?
We have.
So without any further ado, let's start with round one. It's the mystery guess round. Susan, I'm going to show you a video of a celebrity in disguise. All you need to do is guess who it is. Do you understand?
I do.
Okay then, watch this very carefully.
I will. Hacker, it's obviously you.
The clip's not finished yet, Sue.
It's a waste of time. It's obviously you.
Be patient, love. So what's your answer?
Is it Hacker?
Well, let's have a little look, shall we?
Who's that gardener?
It's actually Philip Tufnell.
No.
That was just something I shot in the Blue Peter garden the other day.
Oh.
Yeah, it's hairier than I realised, actually.
Yeah.
So the score stands at 307. It's time for the second round. Home or away? Would you like a home question or an away question?
I'll have a home question, please, Hacker.
Good choice. Sue Barker, do you have laminate flooring or do you prefer a vinyl finish?
No, I think you've got a bit mixed up.
No. I said, no. Do you have laminate flooring or do you prefer a vinyl finish?
No, but if it's a home question, it's about your home sport, so you should ask me something about tennis. Not about my floor.
But I don't know a thing about tennis, Sue.
But that's what this quiz is all about.
I don't know what I'm doing, Sue. I'm not all there. Shall we try an away question, then?
OK, yeah, go away question, then.
Right, then. Sue Barker, how much do you weigh?
What? You can't ask that.
I said away, in a way.
away question is supposed to be about any sport other than tennis. It's about sport.
All right, Sue, stop harping on. Let's do the last round. This is sprint finish.
Can't wait.
Okay, this is about sport and that. There are 30 seconds on the clock and I'm going to ask you some questions. All you've got to do is say the answers. Do you understand?
What could possibly go wrong?
Probably quite a lot, Sue. Start the clock, please. Name a tennis player.
Roger Federer.
Wrong. Steffi Graf. Oh. What are Queen's Park Rangers?
Football team.
Nil. People that work in the Queen's Royal Parks, of course. Come on, Sue. Where do Manchester United play?
Old Trafford.
No, wherever the game is that weekend.
OK.
What was the score?
I don't know.
7, it was. Name the Russian gymnast.
Komova.
Nil.
Mustafina.
Still wrong. How?
What?
When? Why?
Why what?
Time up! What was the score, guys?
Did I get any right?
I've lost count, Hacker.
Ooh, and I can't count, Hacker. Oh, heck, what a pair of mooies. Right, Sue, next round is what happens next?
Yeah.
Well, go on then, what happens next?
Well, no, you show me a clip and then I have a guess at what happens next.
What are you on about, Sue? I literally don't know what happens next. I left the last page of my script on the printer. I've no idea what happens now.
Hacker.
Oh, Sue, I think that maybe you are better at doing quizzes than I am after all.
Oh.
I better stick to my day job. Hold on, what is my day job? Anyway, I know what you will like, Susan. It's my top drawer gritty detective drama, Sherlock Bones. And today something happens to a sofa. Or is it a suite? Oh, I don't know. It'll all become clear, I'm sure. Run it, Derek!
This is the sinister town of Teapot,
where trouble's always brewing like a teapot. Off again!
And once the prince promised never to stroke llamas again, they all lived happily ever after.
I'm not asleep! Tell me another story.
Hello? Sherlock, there's been an incident. Mr. Sherbet from the sweet shop's just lost his three-piece sweet.
This is a case for me.
I can only serve you one at a time, but rest assured, there are enough nails for everyone.
Yay! It's a bit busy in here today, ain't it? But since the entire town's here, it's important to know that there's been an incident. Mr. Sherbet has had his three-piece sweet stolen.
What flavour was the sweet?
No, his three-piece sweet.
Why is he eating pea-flavoured sweets?
I don't know. He's probably some sort of sicko or something, I don't know.
Unless he's lost three peas.
Why would he only eat three peas?
I think what we're talking about here is his sofa and chairs, you know. His three-piece sweet.
Why is he using sweet-free meat as lounge furniture?
Oh, just hang on. I'll be right back.
Oh.
Let's not fight.
Mr. Sherbet, have you lost your... three-piece sweet, your three-piece sweet, or your three-peas, comma, sweet, used as an exclamation.
Oh, well, I did have a sweet that I sold for 3p, but I found it, no, it was behind the 4p sweet, it's 5p.
Total waste of police time. I'm livid. False alarm, everyone! It was his sweet costing 3p, but he's found it now. It was behind his 4p sweet.
4p sweet? How can he afford 3 armchairs and a sofa in this day and age? Yeah. Let's get him!
I'll go on then. Let's get him. Hey, good actoring, wasn't it, Sue?
Cool, it was. Very good, yeah.
Oh, Susan, we've had a lovely time today, haven't I?
Well, I have too. It's been a lot of fun.
Sue?
What?
I thought that maybe after the show that... me and you could go out and get a nice chilled beverage or something.
Oh, Hacker, well, I'd love to.
Really?
But no, Sam, I'm not tonight. No, I can't. Sorry. I'm busy.
Busy? Okay. Don't worry, Sue. Maybe another time.
Yes.
See you then.
Is that it then?
Yep. Hit the music, Derek. Off you go, Sue.
That's all the coverage of Sue Barker we've got time for today, but tune in later when John Inverdale will have the coverage of all today's Sue Barker-based lives.
Ain't she lovely? Now she's pushed off, though, I'll show you some of my favourite sporting lols from around this glorious world of ours. It's time for... Hackers Top 5 Sporting Howlers! In at 5, it's the Miracle Bowler. Oh, good, come on. Oh, he's gone spur! Oh, good work, sir. It'd be a miracle if I managed to hit anything. I've got arms like an old dishcloth. Now, as we know, I'm terrible at football, but even I knew how to kick a ball. Right in the fam squash. Get it in the net, son. Come on, it's massive. No. What an embarrassment. Come on, boys, take some tips from me. Nil. In at 3, whoever said office jobs are boring? Well, I did, actually, because they are. Or are they? These guys have got far too much time on their hands. Answer the phone, it could be important. You might be entitled to PPI refund. It's all fun and games now, but wait till the cleaner catches you lot. Oh, then you'll be far in. Did you know that not all sports take place on the land? Have a look at these aquatic beauties. Oh, look, he's gotten moist again. Stay on the land, son, you're not a duck. What are you playing at? Oh, look at you, showing off. Hold on to... Yep. Oh, you'll never get your money back. What a soggy nonsense. And today's number one features some mind-blowing basketball tricks. Look at them go!
He'll never get that in. It went in! He'll never get this in now. He'll never... It went in! That'll never go in. No chance. It's gone in!
You think that's impressive? You should watch me slam dunk a bicky in me tea. Anyway, thanks for watching my television show today. It's been a right good one, hasn't it? I'm off now to wait for the many awards to be delivered, so I'll see you next time. All that's left to do today is for me to sing my well-good song. Join in if you know the words! That is it for now, the end of the show. I need the lab love, so I'm going to go. I'll see you next time on this show of mine. Put it in your diary, it's called Hacker Time. It's been amazing, we've been lurking around. And we've been lolling at some clips that I found. We'll watch again next time, cause I got much more. There'll be tons of other funny stuff, it will be top draw. We did sporting stuff today with the lovely Susan Barker. She's a charming girl with a handsome face, and I do believe she's better than a permanent marker. That is it for now, the end of the show. I need the love labs, so I'm going to go. I'll see you next time on this show of mine. Put it in your diary, it's called Hacker Time. Put it in your diary, it's called Hacker Time. That is the end of today's Hacker Time.
Poker face, woohoo, poker face, ooh.